Video 2 on the threefold perception in open-eyed meditation. The first video I talked about how to override blinking, like this, see, because it's just a natural human instinct to do this when something unusual happens in the meditative state, especially open-eyed meditation. Because it's coming over the background of everything else, and it's you're conserving the energy. But anyways, this is video 2, and this is going into the threefold perception. Now, when the yogis put three dots on a piece of paper or toilet paper, and they hang it down, and they make you look at all three dots at once. Why is that? Why did they make you look at three dots instead of two or just one? Why? Because there's three layers of perception and three dimensions. That's why. And that's where we're at, and that's what we're going through to the next. So to progress out of the three dimensions, going into this ascension and higher state, higher self, you must master and overcome the three full perception in the three dimensions, 3D. So what happens is you have to be able to look at all three layers. So if I'm looking out, okay, and I'm meditating, now I've got me as the first dot. I could see my legs and hands even though I'm looking out that way. See? Number two, I could see the normal view. That's number two. And number three is the focus point, where the energy is coming from. So you have to be able to look at all three of these at the same time, and not separately. All at, literally at the same time. So what you do, and a good way to do this threefold perception is with the clouds. This is a good way to practice this. You have to be able to withstand high light. Your eyes have to adjust. But anyways, for the ones that are advanced in this, I shouldn't have to explain it. So when you're looking out, and you're doing open-eyed meditation. Now, one of the main focus points is, of course, your third eye. Now, wherever you put your third eye is going to be your focus point. And now, when you're meditating, you don't want to look at just the third eye. You want to be able to see the third eye, the clouds surrounding it, and the backdrop at the same time. If you could do that, something magical happens. And if you could hold it long enough, that's when the true powerful things happen. That's when you start to master the threefold perception. Now, in video 3, I'm going to put together an example, a more photographic example of this, for you to practice this technique.